Abdelberry, the choice was simple: stay in Syria and die, or flee. She chose life, and after months of running, ended up here with her two daughters at the Karatepe camp on the Greek island of Lesbos. Her husband and two sons, she tells us, fled Syria 7 months earlier and are already in Germany. My husband says if it was up to me, I'd bring you here right away. But you have to wait for permission from European officials, she tells me. I'm not here for a handout, but I want to see my children. I haven't seen my seven-year-old son in 7 months. Her temporary home, a basic UNHCR prefab. No running water, no power. Abdelbedri's family remains divided while she waits on her asylum application. She's told it could take months. A story that mirrors many at Karatepe, a camp designed to welcome the more vulnerable refugees, women and children, or the badly injured.
But it's a very different situation here at the other camp on the island called Moria. It is closed, it's very controlled, there's even riot police parked outside. We've even been told we're not allowed to film the front gates.
When asked why we didn't have access, officials wouldn't give us a reason. Here, the walls surrounding the Moria camp have been freshly painted white in anticipation of Pope Francis's visit to Lesbos on Saturday. Elsewhere on the island, gone are the scenes of mass exodus and desperation of just a few months ago. Now refugees remain confined to enclosed camps, and the migrants and refugees who've managed to travel farther are stuck at closed borders between Greece and Macedonia. For families in limbo here, waiting is now all they can do.